Hello guys, this is Ravens from DJ Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 118. According to new research from Strategy Analytics, half the world's entire population now owns a smartphone in June 2021. Some 4 billion people use a smartphone today. It has taken 27 years to reach this historic milestone. Facebook's Instagram is testing a feature that lets users post photos and videos from their desktop computers. After more than a decade without the capability, to improve the experience, they are now testing the ability to create a feed post on Instagram with their desktop browser. After PUBG's relaunch in India as Battlegrounds Mobile India, TikTok appears to be all set to make a comeback in the country as well. The Chinese short video app has reportedly started discussion with the Indian government officials and is assuring the authorities that it will fully comply with the new IT rules on social media platforms. Official of TikTok's parent company, ByteDance, reportedly approached the IT ministry and PM officials and reiterated that the short video platform will follow fully comply with the new IT rules. Amazon was found destroying over 6 million unsold items every year. A small portion of the unsold inventory was also marked for donation. The UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson has promised to look into the allegations. Microsoft announced Windows 11 this week. The new version of Windows should be available as a free upgrade to users, but not all PCs will support it. While there are requirements for new version, you can simply install the PC Health Check app to know if your system will be supported or not. Are you a fan of Looney Tunes? If your answer is yes, then you are the most likely looking forward to the arrival of Space Jam 2 or Space Jam A New Legacy on July 16. Ahead of the premiere of the show, Xbox has announced a limited edition collection of Xbox wireless controllers themed after this movie. A New Legacy exclusive Xbox wireless controller are available in 3 versions, Tune Squad, Serververse and Goon Squad. All 3 versions will be available on July 8th for $69.99 per unit. Samsung Galaxy Bud 2 official render show off the complete design and color option. The True Wireless Earbuds will come in white, black, purple and green color. Samsung Galaxy Bud 2 True Wireless Earbuds are expected to launch on June 28. Samsung Galaxy A22 price in India have been revealed. The phone is priced at ₹18,499 for the 6GB and 128GB model. Samsung Galaxy A22 is available through offline retail stores. Automaker Ford subsidiary Spin is making steady inroads into the micro-mobility segment with the launch of its first Volley-produced e-scooter. The S100T scooter bears the strongest imprimatur of Ford design philosophy that embodies durability and safety. Oppo unveiled the Oppo Reno 6 series in China in late May. The lineup includes 3 devices, namely Oppo Reno 6 5G, Oppo Reno 6 Pro 5G and Oppo Reno 6 Pro Plus 5G. One of these smartphones is now being reported to launch in India in the coming weeks. The Oppo Reno smartphone for India is just around the corner. According to the reports, the Chinese handset maker is expected to launch the Oppo Reno 6 Pro 5G in mid-July. In late Feb, Xiaomi unveiled the Mi Neckband Bluetooth Earphones Pro in India. The audio accessories went on sale starting March 1st, nearly 4 months after their release. These earphones have now been spotted on Poco's branding on BIS. Now, as per BIS, Poco could also launch a pair of neckband style earphones. These accessories is listed with model number, which is identical to that of Mi Neckband Bluetooth Earphones Pro. In fact, these two products were certified on the same day on March 1st. Phones with bendable display are all the craze. Lately, and it is no surprise that major manufacturers are jumping on the bandwagon. Even Vivo plans to release a foldable handset until the end of this year. Or at least that's what some reports are saying. The latest evidence comes from the Chinese trademark office. On May 24, Vivo has trademarked not one but 3 Nex devices. Nex Lite, Nex Fold and Nex Roll. Their names are pretty self-explanatory, but the new bit is that the new form of factor handset will exist under the Nex branding. Hawaii confirmed just a couple of days ago that their brand new Nova 8i smartphone is headed to Southeast Asia and also disclosing a few major specifications. This phone adopts a Mate 30 Pro-like look with a circular camera module carrying 4 shooters and an LED flash positioned next to it. It may be due to the render itself, but the back glass looks more curved than usual and the side frame is pretty thin too. The volume rocker and power button, which mostly certainly doubles as a fingerprint reader too, are placed on the right side next to each other. Chip manufacturers have processed significantly over the past few years by launching smartphone processor with a 5-nanometer fabrication. The current set of flagship smartphones in India and around the world feature a 5-nanometer Snapdragon chiplet developed by Qualcomm. MediaTek, which is amongst the most popular chip makers, is lagging behind by its 6-nanometer Dimensity 1200 processor. Although the powerful and efficient, it falls behind its Qualcomm counterpart. Reports suggest that 5-nanometer MediaTek processor could launch in 2022. TSMC is planning to start the test production of 4-nanometer processor in the third quarter of 2021. The new 4-nanometer chip will be offered increased performance while providing improved power efficiency. The report states that MediaTek is among the first set of companies to co-develop a 4-nanometer processor with TSMC. The Taiwan-based company wants to develop a 4-nanometer flagship processor that will power premium smartphones upon launch. As per the current timeline reported, the 4-nanometer could be commercially ready by the first half of the next year. A number of manufacturers such as Xiaomi, Samsung, Oppo, and Vivo have already placed orders with MediaTek. The new 4-nanometer chips run with ARM version 9 architecture. It will have Cortex-X2 and Cortex-A510 cores. It will be speculated that the GPU paired with processor will be the Mali-G710. This could be a big boost for MediaTek to compete against Qualcomm and Apple, which currently offer a 5-nanometer chip. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.